respondents and is a likelihood to breach conditions of release, as the three respondents are police officers and know the operations of the National Police. In addition, there is likelihood of breach as it is suspected that the three respondents are in collusion with the escaped murder suspect. In this instance, therefore, the key objective is to balance the rights of the respondents, the interests of justice and public order, peace and security. It is in the public domain that the escaped suspect confessed to killing children in various locations. He is not only a dangerous man, but one who puts the state in an awkward and embarrassing position with its citizens, whom it is mandated to protect and be seen to protect with diligence and rigor. The three respondents are ranked as inspector of police and police constables, respectively. There is need to balance their rights to freedom vis-à-vis the right of potential witnesses in the matter of the escaped suspect. The issue of the escaped suspect creates anxiety in the public and endangers the general public and also endangers the life of the escaped suspect. The respondents hearing allege that their actions were beyond their control as the state machinery was not employed to assist them in their duties. In fact, they said that the lack of electricity contributed to the escape of the suspect in their custody. The police investigators seek to have investigation to establish the link between the respondents and the escaped suspect. In doing so, the court, if persuaded to grant bond terms, must also safeguard the provisions of Section 123A of the Criminal Procedure Code that spells out the parameters of granting bond. That is including the nature and the seriousness of the offense. In this case, it is the offense of aiding a prisoner to escape and the strength of the evidence that is going to be given. Are the respondents dangerous citizens to amount the court detaining them? That is a question. A balance must be placed to safeguard their rights as guaranteed in the Constitution. The reasons advanced by Mr. Kimathi, who represented the state, seem logical and reasonable, and I ask myself, will holding the respondents in police custody dissipate the public order, peace, and security as the police search for a serial killer? I find that upon examination of the law and the facts as presented, that the holding of the respondents could indeed be reasonable to aid the state more with speed and conclude the investigations. The ODPP is granted a mandate to prosecute matters on behalf of the police, and it does so by examining the evidence before a charge is prepared in court. In this case, the respondents ask the court to order the ODPP to charge the respondents with a known offense, but the state opposes this and states that it needs time to gather more evidence. The complexity of these investigations are well explained, noting the escaped suspect is a danger to society. In this regard, finally, I find as follows.